Now the Starship SN4 has completed two static fire tests. When can we finally see the first hopping test and the 20 km skydive maneuver? Then we also have to talk about Artemis and SLS. Elon made an epic tweet about the SLS and how Democrats are disappointed with NASA's choice of the three moon landers. We wonder why. And to everyone's surprise, the Lunar Gateway is on again for 2023. And who will most likely launch it? That's right, SpaceX with their Falcon Heavy. Take that, Blue Origin.
And next, the US government is preparing the Artemis Accords, which will pave the way for moon mining. But even more insane, Tom Cruise, Elon Musk, and NASA are teaming up to shoot the first action movie in space.
There's nothing part of the way for me.
And in case you cannot wait so long, let's take a look at the recruitment video of Space Force. It's without Tom Cruise, but still pretty epic. And lastly, China has successfully launched their new space capsule. So what exactly are China's future plans? A lot to talk about as always, so stay tuned.
So finally, we could witness the first Raptor engine fire in the Starship SN4 prototype. And we are extremely glad that nothing went wrong this time. In fact, everything went perfectly smooth. SpaceX performed two static fire tests in a row with a single Raptor engine in Starship SN4.
This was a giant milestone. Afterwards, we remember that the Raptor engine was dismounted from SN4. Because SN4 was to undergo cryogenic pressure tests again, and it survived these tests unharmed, even though the pressure went quite a lot higher than during the first cryo test 2 weeks ago. Because we remember that back then, SN4 passed a pressure with liquefied nitrogen of only 4.9 bar. Many were underwhelmed. But now, it passed a pressure of 7.5 bar. Which is 25% higher than the minimum of 6 bar needed for orbital flights. And it's just shy of the 8.5 bar needed for human-rated spaceflight safety margins, which require Starship to withstand pressures of 40% higher than the minimum 6 bar. So it looks as if Starship is really getting there, which is great news. Because Starship has to fly humans to space at some point, right? Next for SN4 will be now the installation of a new Raptor engine and then the 150 meter hopping test, which could happen as soon as later this week. Insane but true.
After the hopping test, SN5 will get 3 Raptor engines installed and will try to perform the very delicate skydive maneuver from a height of 20 kilometers. After that, SN6 will probably become the first Starship prototype to perform orbital flight tests. The orbital flights will most likely happen by the end of 2020.
Now regarding SLS, Elon made a quite funny tweet which perfectly describes the emotions of every sane person when confronted with the SLS. He said, "SLS makes me sad." Yes, Elon, it also makes us sad, very sad in fact. So sad that it will be our holy duty on this channel here to continue bashing SLS and expose the insanity of SLS every time we can. We will only stop bashing SLS when this monstrosity is retired by Starship. Because you know, a completely expendable rocket which costs $2 billion per launch and can only launch once per year is maybe not such a good idea somehow. But we mentioned in our last week's space report, which you can watch right here, that NASA is slowly, very slowly and carefully, starting to turn away from SLS towards SpaceX.
Because NASA is not only hiring SpaceX to resupply the Lunar Gateway with Dragon XL and Falcon Heavy, but they also awarded SpaceX a portion of the Artemis Human Landing System award to build a moon lander version of Starship. Now everyone of course knows that Starship is far superior to the other selected moon landers. However, still somebody is not happy with NASA's decision. In fact, the leaders of the House Science Committee seem to be quite unhappy with NASA's decision on the Artemis moon landers. For example, Democratic Representative A.D. Bernice Johnson said in a statement on the 1st of May. "I'm troubled that NASA has decided to ignore congressional intent and instead press forward with human landing system awards to try to meet an arbitrary 2024 lunar landing deadline." Arbitrary. LOL. And another Democratic representative, Kendra Horn, said, "I was disappointed to see that NASA's decision on lunar landing systems development starkly contrasts the bipartisan House NASA authorization bill and the advice of experts on minimizing risk and ensuring the highest likelihood of success in landing humans on the moon."
Yeah, we bet these two Democratic representatives are really, really disappointed that NASA really wants to land on the moon on the very arbitrary landing date of 2024, right? Let's just think of the real reasons why they might not like this. Wow, that's really difficult to figure out. What exactly is in 2024? Ah yes, if Trump gets re-elected, the first American astronauts since 1972 would return to the moon during his presidency. Now why exactly wouldn't Democrats like this? That's a difficult question again. Why exactly wouldn't they like it? It's so freaking difficult. What could it be? This is another classic example of politicians putting their stupid ideologies above the good of the nation and above the good of mankind. Hey, who needs the advancement of technology, of humankind, when we can have a childish win over the evil orange man, right? Because we all know that Trump is so evil, the leftist media is telling us time and time again. Therefore, we must do everything possible to deny him any possible victory, even if this is to the absolute detriment of the United States of America. Gotta love these politicians. This is the same level of short-sighted thinking as Nixon canceling Apollo back in the day. Something which we will never forgive Nixon. F***ing hate Nixon. Nixon, I'm gonna...
But NASA is unimpressed by this and presses on with Artemis. Like a boss. And like a boss, NASA are now dropping hints that SpaceX will not only resupply the Lunar Gateway, but most likely SpaceX will also launch the Lunar Gateway itself to a moon orbit on a Falcon Heavy. So first, it's noteworthy that suddenly the Lunar Gateway is back again into the first Artemis moon landings. We remember that only 2 months ago, NASA decided to conduct the early moon surface landing missions, so Artemis 3 and Artemis 4 without the Lunar Gateway in 2024. However, now the Lunar Gateway seems to be back in the game, as NASA confirmed last week in their statement to spacepolicyonline.com. Douglas Lovera, chief of NASA's human spaceflight program, even said that NASA was looking into the most promising launch vehicles for the Lunar Gateway. And to no surprise, Falcon Heavy is the number one on that list. As we know, Falcon Heavy can lift a payload of up to 20 metric tons to translunar injection. Therefore, it would be absolutely capable of launching the first two Lunar Gateway modules, the HALO and the PPE modules, to a near rectilinear HALO orbit around the moon in 2023. Of course, a larger payload fairing will be necessary. But how convenient that Falcon Heavy will indeed receive a larger payload fairing in the near future. Because some military launches also require a larger payload fairing. We can already see it in this render here, showing Falcon Heavy with a larger payload fairing together with the new vertical integration tower.
Blue Origin's new Glenn, though, was strangely not mentioned by NASA. We wonder why. Could it be because all we've ever seen of Blue Origin's new Glenn rocket is half a payload fairing and some fancy CGI? Could it maybe have something to do with that? Anyways, so let's recap. Not only will SpaceX most likely launch the Lunar Gateway itself with Falcon Heavy, not only will SpaceX then resupply the Gateway with the Dragon XL launched also by the Falcon Heavy, but no, SpaceX is even developing a lunar variant of Starship as a possible moon lander. It is all coming together perfectly.
Everything is proceeding as I have foreseen. Ha 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 ha!
Now, in some really bizarre but strangely also very awesome news, Tom Cruise is planning to shoot the first action movie in space. Details about this project are yet sparse, but we know that Cruise will be launched with a Crew Dragon to the ISS, as indicated by this tweet of Jim Bridenstine, and Elon is involved because he thinks it will be a lot of fun. Now let's hope that this will bring Tom Cruise one step closer to become an operating titan, or operating Titan, or whatever those Scientology wackos call the highest form of being, you know? We have to say Tom Cruise certainly is a crazy guy in his way. But this movie could be really inspiring to a new generation of moviegoers and help to further grow the public interest in spaceflight. So we think it's a really awesome development. And hopefully we will see more insane Tom Cruise outbursts in the future because of that.
Yes! Yes!
17 magazine. Yes!
But if you are very impatient for the Tom Cruise movie and want to watch some epic stuff right now, watch the new recruitment trailer for the Space Force. Indeed, it seems that Starship Troopers wasn't even exaggerating so much with its satiric depiction of military pathos. It's really worth a watch, and we have to say even we get this really weird patriotic feeling when watching it. It even contains a really interesting looking space station with rotating segments. Now, we are sure the Space Force does not have such a space station, but hey, it certainly looks cool.
In other patriotic developments, the Trump administration is drafting a legal blueprint for mining the moon under a new US-sponsored international agreement called the Artemis Accords. Say what you will about Trump, but this guy is doing more for human spaceflight than the last presidents combined. And yes, moon mining will be huge. This is absolutely clear. Only recently, this new moon map was released showing the locations of interesting moon resources which could be mined. It was clear that moon mining will happen. Many sci-fi movies already predicted this a long time ago. The moon will play a crucial role in the future of mankind and space exploration in general. We will talk more about the moon in our future Friday videos because we think it's crucial to first build a moon base and only after that aim for Mars. Anyways, the Artemis Accord is a really good plan. Even more so, as China has also set its sight on the moon.
And the first step towards that direction was China's launch of a Long March 5B rocket last week on Tuesday, carrying the next generation space capsule on an uncrewed flight into orbit. The mission was successful, the capsule landed safely again on Earth, and this will be an important step for China since the new space capsule will lay the foundation for trips to China's planned space station, which will be assembled using a Long March 5B rocket. The capsule is quite large and can seat up to 7 taikonauts, and the very same capsule will be used in some configuration for future crewed moon round trips and eventually for crewed moon landings. And China is very openly re-emphasizing their plans to land people on the moon by 2030 and build a moon base in the following years. Exciting times on the moon for sure. It will be highly interesting to see how this moon race will develop. Now, we personally think it might go down something like this. But joking aside, the more nations we will have on the moon to construct moon bases, to mine the moon, to live on the moon, the better for all of humanity.
So it's a real surprise to us that the Lunar Gateway is back in the game again, and Falcon Heavy might be selected to launch it.
And what do you say to the insane Tom Cruise space action movie news? I mean, what is next? A remake of Predator on the moon with Arnold Schwarzenegger? So you just watched the Monday Space Report, and this Friday we will talk about the cool new white moon starship. So be sure to subscribe so that you don't miss the video.
So thanks for watching, and I'd say On to the future. Terminator is better.
Terminator on the moon with Arnold Schwarzenegger, that would be awesome. Anyways. So now, what?
So now we finish the Starship flow fix theories.
And Starship again, flow fix. Okay.